Hi everyone, welcome to JavaTiki. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to build Docker image using Jenkins. So before we start this DevOps integration, you should have basic knowledge about how to work with Docker and Jenkins. At least you should know some basic command to play with Docker. Okay, so if you know this concept, then we are good to go. Else, don't worry guys, you can check out my Docker and Jenkins playlist where I explain from scratch. So this is what the Docker playlist and this is what the Jenkins playlist. I will add this link in video description so that you guys can grab it. Okay. All right. So this is what I'm going to demonstrate. We'll create one GitHub repository and that repo will integrate with Jenkins so that each code commit to my GitHub, Jenkins will process continuous integration and deployment. Once the Jenkins build is succeed, then Jenkins will create Docker image for us and he will push that Docker image to Docker Hub. Okay, here we are not going to create Docker image manually, even we are not going to push that Docker image to Docker Hub. Okay, all that Dockerization stuff will be done by Jenkins itself. Okay, so let's follow this diagram in action. Let's get started. Let's go to our IntelliJ IDE. So first we'll create one small Java project and that Java project will sync with our GitHub. Then that GitHub will link with Jenkins. Okay. So first let me create one small Maven project. Click next. Give the group ID as com.javatiki. Specify the artifact ID as Docker Jenkins integration sample, something like that. Click next. Click finish, open it in new window. Yeah, so project got imported. Let me close this, enable auto import. So go to this SRC. So we don't want to add any code here. We are just going to launch the integration stop. Okay, so what I can do, I'll just specify the jar name here. So I'll add build. Then we can give the final name. And I will specify this Docker Jenkins integration sample. Okay. Now once I will run Maven install, the jar will be created with this name. That's it, I added only. So now what we can do, we need to sync this Java project to GitHub, right? So go to your GitHub account. I will create a new project here. So we'll give the same name. Create repository. Now we need to run this command. Okay, so go to your project. So go to the terminal. I'll type the command here, git init. Then we'll do git status to check what are the file we need to commit. Yeah, so first I will add all the file. Okay, now I need to commit it with some message. What I'll give something like first commit. Yeah, we committed the file. Now if I'll check the git status, there is nothing to commit. Okay, now I need to sync with this GitHub repo. So what I can do, I'll copy this command. Go to your IntelliJ terminal, paste it. Yeah, now I need to push all the changes to that repo, isn't it? So I will go to this and I will copy this command. So here you can see all changes pushed successfully. Now if you will go to your GitHub repo and if you will refresh it, you can see all the file. Okay. So now what we need to do? We need to integrate this GitHub repository with Jenkins, isn't it? So if you see this diagram, we are done with these two steps. We created code base and we sync with GitHub. Now this GitHub need to sync with Jenkins. Okay. So what I will do, where I install the Jenkins, I will go to that directory and I will type your command and I need to run the Jenkins var. Okay. java-jar jenkins.var. By default, it will run on port 8080. But if you want to run in different port, you can add that command, HTTP port, then give the port number. Okay, so let it complete. Yeah, so you can see here Jenkins is fully up and running, right? So to verify whether Jenkins server is up or not, go to your browser. Just hit the URL localhost 8080. It should redirect you to the Jenkins dashboard. Okay, so what we are going to do next, create new job. So you can give the name here, we'll give something like Jenkins Docker integration. Okay, and click on this freestyle project, click OK. Then after that, you can see this page. Here you need to click on GitHub project and you need to give your project URL. This is what the project URL. Then come down, source code management, you need to choose Git, and here you need to provide the repository URL. So go to your GitHub and click on this clone or download, copy this, again go to your Jenkins, paste it here. Here you no need to provide any credential because GitHub is public repo, isn't it? So come down. Now here you need to click on this pull SCM. I just want to run my Jenkins in each commit. Okay, so that's why I need to give your 5-star. This is the cron expression which I provided. You can see here, do you really mean every minute when you say? Okay, so then come down, and here I can add high level Maven goal. Here I will just give the goal as install. Okay, so that each commit to my GitHub after Jenkins integrate, it will run this install goal. Okay, now click on apply and save it. So for testing purpose, just give one build. You started the build. You can check the console output. You can see here, this is what our first commit changes. So let it complete. Yeah, build is succeed here. And it created a jar with the name which we provided in our pom.xml. Isn't it? The same name we provided as a final name. So let's go back to our diagram. As per this diagram, we already integrate our code with GitHub and that GitHub with Jenkins. And just now we started one build, isn't it? So to verify my GitHub and Jenkins both are in sync, what we need to do? Let's go to the IntelliJ and let's do some change in our code so that we'll push the changes and we'll notice whether Jenkins has started the CI/CD or not. That's how we can verify the sync between Jenkins and GitHub. Okay, so what I will do, I will just add one small Java class, test, something like that, add it, and then I will write something like public static void main, and I will add some s out, I will give hello. Okay, save it. Now what I will do, instead of using this terminal, I will use the IntelliJ shortcut, go to version control, and I want to add all. Okay. Yeah. So here I'll add the commit message, second commit. And I will commit and push. This is what the commit message, right? Now it is suggesting me for push. You can see here, pushed one commit to origin master. Now if you will go to your GitHub and if you will refresh it, we can see our commit message, right? This is what the second commit. We added one test class and couple of file also we pushed it, isn't it? So as I pushed my changes just now, Jenkins should able to process the continuous integration and deployment. So let's go to Jenkins and go to our main. Yeah. If you observe, Jenkins already started and it succeeded. Go to the console output. You can see the last commit message, right? Once we did the commit, Jenkins automatically start the continuous integration. Basically, he start the build, which we provided the build command as install, right? He will just execute the Maven goal. And that build is succeed. This is what the time. Okay. So we are good. Now, as per the diagram, we need to integrate Jenkins with Docker, isn't it? So we sync with GitHub and Jenkins. Now the next step is we need to integrate Jenkins with Docker. Okay, so what we can do, you just go to your Jenkins. We need to add one plugin. Okay, so if you'll go to this Jenkins homepage, there is an option called Manage Jenkins. Click on this. If you'll come down, there is an option called Manage Plugins. Click on this. Yeah, now click on this available and go to this filter, type here Docker. You can find some few plugin related to Docker. As I already installed, I can see it in install section. Go to this install and here I will search Docker. You can observe here, it got tick mark, already I installed it. Okay, same plugin you need to add, CloudBees Docker build and publish plugin, and one more you need, Docker plugin. Okay, Docker build step. These three plugin we need to add, and these three you can search here directly in available. So to verify whether those plugin installed successfully or not, just go to your Jenkins homepage and then click on your project, click on configure. If you'll come down in build section, you should get the option. If you'll click on this, you should get this option, build publish Docker image. And one more option is also there related to Docker. Let me show you that. Yeah, Docker build and publish. Okay, so this if you can see this, then your plugin installed successfully. Now go back to our diagram. So our GitHub sync with Jenkins, and in Jenkins we added Docker related plugin, right? Now, how Jenkins will understand your Java code that we need to create a Docker image? How we can instruct to Jenkins, take this code and build a Docker image for us? So for that, we need to provide the Docker file in our code, isn't it? In our Java code, we'll add Docker file and that we'll push to the GitHub. Now, Jenkins will load it from GitHub and he will process the build. Once that build is succeed, Jenkins is able to create the Docker image and he can push it to the Docker Hub. This is what all about we learned, isn't it? Now let's add the Docker file in our Java code base. Then let's see how Jenkins will help us. Okay, so go to your IntelliJ. So let me save this. Yeah. So here we need to add one file called Docker file. So new file, we can name it as Docker file. Add it. And then we need to add the Docker file related stuff, isn't it? Add the properties here. So we need to add from expose port, and then we need to give the jar, okay, and command to run the jar. This is what Docker file we need to add it. Now save it. What I will do, I will go to my version control. I want to commit all, control K. I will give the message called added Docker file. Now I will push it. Once my changes will push to the GitHub, now Jenkins will start the build automatically. We can check that directly. Okay, yeah, so file pushed successfully. Now if you will go to your browser and you can see here, Jenkins already start the build, which is the third build. Okay, so to verify it, go to console output. You can see this message, right? This is what our last commit, added Docker file, isn't it? Now if you'll go to diagram, Jenkins, we added the plugin, and in our code we already added the Docker file, right? Now we just need to give instruction to Jenkins, create a Docker image, read my Docker file and create a Docker image, then push it to the Docker Hub, isn't it? So for that I need to give my Docker Hub credential to Jenkins. So what we can do, go to our Jenkins, go to this project, click on configure and come down here, click on this add build step. There is a option called Docker build and publish, so click on this. So if you'll come down here, you can see there is a option called repository name. Okay, So repository name, basically I need to give the tag name. So first let me log into my Docker Hub. So you can see my Docker Hub. This is what my tag name, JavaTeki. So what I will do, I will give the tag name JavaTeki, and then I need to give my image name, Docker image name. Okay, so I will go to the code, I will copy the same name. With this name, I want to create a Docker image. That's what we specify in our Docker file, isn't it? So add it here. And apart from that, we need to add the Docker Hub credential. I already added it. You just need to provide your own Docker Hub credential. That's it. Now apply and save it. Now start a build. Yeah, so let me go to the console. You can see here, once our Maven build is succeed, Jenkins started the preparing Docker image. So it execute all the four steps which we specify in our Docker Hub. Now it is preparing the Docker image and it will push to the Docker Hub. So that we can verify in our Docker Hub once it is succeed. Yeah, you can see here it got succeed. Now if you will go to your Docker Hub and if you will refresh it, you should see the Docker image. Yeah, Docker Jenkins integration sample, right? This is what the Docker image we created, and that Jenkins push to our Docker Hub. So if you open this, you can pull it and you can reuse it. We didn't add any description and all. So to verify that, what we can do, go to our Docker terminal. I will run here Docker images. I can see the image which we created just now. This is what we created, isn't it? About a minute ago. And the same Docker image pushed to the Docker Hub by Jenkins. So this is how we can do full-fledged DevOps integration from Java code to GitHub, then GitHub to Jenkins, and from Jenkins to Docker Hub. So if you want me to prepare more video about this DevOps integration, do let me know in comment section. Yeah. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.